Hello again, and with the European Championship final due to kick off in about 20 minutes' time in the Olympic Stadium Munich, we're off for the moment to Luton Town FC, equally evocative for some, where tonight Barry McGuigan continues his stirring comeback against Thomas de Cruz at Super Featherweight, a fight you can see exclusively on ITV tonight. Dickie Davis reports now from Kenilworth Road.
Well, it's another June outdoor adventure for Barry McGuigan. 3 years ago at Queen's Park Rangers, he beat Eusebio Pedrosa to win the WBA featherweight title. And today, here at Luton Town's ground, he faces the Brazilian Thomas de Cruz. A good win, and he could get another crack at a world championship. As you can see, the final preparations are almost complete. The setting is going to be absolutely superb. Over 15,000 fight fans are expected, and that means well over £1 million. Such is the interest in this fight, it's going to be seen live in America. Barry has been training in the peaceful surroundings of Henlow Grange, the Hertfordshire health farm where he's been based for the last 5 weeks. He was in a very relaxed frame of mind as I joined him for his daily stroll by the riverside. And afterwards he told me that he was in the pursuit of excellence.
I'm looking this time to be more accurate, more on the ball. And obviously you always want that perfect round, just like Alain Prost wants the perfect lap. I want the perfect round and being able to throw perfect punch and or the perfect punches.
Well, Thomas de Cruz is the world number four. Do you think you're being a trifle ambitious in taking him in just your second fight back?
If I'm going to be champion again, I've got to beat the best. And he's a big junior lightweight. I picked him because he's big, he's strong, he's number four, and he's number three in the other, or number four in the other ratings as well. So he's a world-class fighter. He's got an impeccable record. And if I'm going to be champion again, I'm going to have to beat boys like this. But that's the reason I've got. It's going to be a very tough fight for me. I'm not underestimating him in any way. But I've got to beat fellas like this if I'm going to be champion again.
Could you explain how crucial this fight is to you?
This is a very important fight to me. It's very, very important. It's a step further. It's a step near the title. It's a step closer to regaining something that I've always wanted and I should never have lost. And it's very, very important.
And your strategy for the fight?
I wouldn't be giving away any clues because I believe he can speak a bit of English and I'm sure he'd probably be listening. So all I'm saying is I'm ready to fight. I'm prepared in every department. He said that he's ready to fight me whatever way I wanted, whether I want to go slam bag from the start or make it a longer fight, he's ready for me. All I can say to him is he better be ready. I'm going to win. And I'm going to win in style, and I hope that whoever out there are in two minds about buying a ticket will go and buy the ticket and come along and see me, because I need all their support. It's going to be a fantastic night, and I want to add to it by winning.
So you can see how important this fight is to the Clonus Cyclone. He's very happy with his training, he's in supreme condition, and he's confident about the fight. He's calling it a semi-final for a world championship, and you can see it with us on ITV tonight. The world of boxing has come to Luton Town. Kenilworth Road has been transformed. It's now a superb outdoor setting for the latest chapter in the McGuigan story. And 15,000 fight fans are here to witness a fight that is absolutely critical to the Irishman. Good evening. Yes, welcome. And the man who has defied that well-worn sporting maxim, Barry McGuigan, takes a speculative step towards another world championship encounter. The opponent, Brazil's Francisco Thomas de Cruz, a tough number four contender for the super featherweight crown. Now, 2 years ago, the desert heat of Las Vegas was too much for Barry McGuigan in his world title defense against Steve de Cruz. It was a distressing venture that seemed to spell the end of a dream. But 22 months later, against many experts' advice, the Ulsterman began his journey on the road back, and he produced this really heartening performance against Nicky Perez.
Now, he's got to be hitting with a straight punch there. Crowd on their feet, but Perez isn't. And Nathan really bellowing in his ear. He's going to let him box on. But for how long now in the fourth? It's all over, bar the shouting, I think. He's taken his stick as much as he can. And I think that's it. He now knows I can't cope with this guy's punching ability. Frustration sets in. He holds his hands high.
Well, although Perez was the second-choice opponent, McGuigan had justified his judgment that he should again hit the World Championship trail. The opponent tonight, Thomas de Cruz, presents a much tougher proposition, despite the fact that in April of last year, he came up against the great Julio Cesar Chavez, perhaps the classiest of all the contemporary world champions. De Cruz was soon out of his depth. Indeed, he was severely punished from the opening bell, and in round three, the referee mercifully intervened. The Brazilian had been crushed. Well, that's only one defeat of two sustained by de Cruz, and that matches, coincidentally, McGuigan's record. With me is Jim Watt. I must say, McGuigan is much happier at Super Feather now, isn't he, Jim?
Yeah, well, against Perez, he showed great power, great strength, and I think the fact that he's happier in his head at 9'4", that will be reflected in his performance.
Now, what about this man de Cruz? He's obviously a tougher proposition, as I said.
He's an excellent opponent, far better than Perez. He's rated in the top half of the world bodies. He'll give McGuigan all sorts of problems. I don't feel he's good enough to defeat McGuigan, but I feel he's good enough to give us a chance to evaluate how much McGuigan has left, how close to the old Barry McGuigan he is. And I'm looking forward to finding that out.
So, you take McGuigan in this one very briefly?
Yes, I would see McGuigan definitely, possibly in the later rounds.
Thank you very much indeed, Jim. Then, a short break now, and then it'll be McGuigan versus de Cruz. And I can tell you that the Irishman is confident.
All I'm saying is I'm ready to fight. I'm prepared in every department. He said that he's ready to fight me whatever way I wanted, whether I want to go slam bag from the start or make it a longer fight. He's ready for me. All I can say to him is he better be ready.
National Boxing outdoors at Luton. The stadium alive with anticipation. We're almost ready for the entry of the Cronus Cyclone, Benny McGuigan. Our ringside team, Jim Watt and Reg Guttridge, are standing by. But now here comes the Brazilian opponent, Thomas de Cruz.
It's a long jog there for Thomas de Cruz. I must say, he's a confident character, speaks very little English, but was shaping up at the weigh-in there and was saying to McGuigan, well, definitely going to go for you, but unfortunately he got the wrong McGuigan. It was his brother Dermot, which is a slightly easier fight. But nonetheless, this fellow's a quality fighter. I covered his fight when he fought the great fighter, Julio Cesar Chavez, and he still finished that fight standing on his feet. I know he was taking plenty of stick, but he wasn't over. Now, if McGuigan gets him down, that is a good performance. 9'3¾", 129¾". So finally found his way then to the ring and gets a little gargle there. They don't have a drink boxes before they get in. Very tall he is, Thomas de Cruz, and he's hoping for a little bit of applause from the crowd, and he just gets some polite applause from the ringside. A bit of booing from the stands there, which is obviously a very Irish, this is an Irish town, I think they call this, Luton, and he's not getting any help from them. The referee is Larry O'Connell, a Londoner, former amateur boxer of quality. And one of the good referees around today, he's on the WBC list. And there's the spot they're going to pick out. The man himself and the cheers. Barry's back again. This fella really does have incredible crowd appeal. He was more worried about that on his first comeback fight against Nicky Perez than the opponent. This time, I think, he's got to worry a little bit more about the opponent. tunnel vision in many ways. Now, he's really dedicated himself to this. Young people are not always keen on that word discipline these days, but in this game, you just got to have it or you don't survive. And certainly Barry McGuigan can do that. He's been holed up in a health farm now for 2 or 3 weeks, quite near his new home in Bedfordshire, the Henlow Grange Farm Health Club. And he likes it there and he gets himself into shape. It's not exactly eating rusty nails back in the Rocky Marciano days and snarling at everybody, but nonetheless, able to concentrate on the job in hand. He knows he's being seen not only across the Great Britain, but also in America. So he's exceptionally popular, of course, despite the fact that the last Cruz he fought actually defeated him, Steve Cruz, the Mexican-American, in that blistering heat in the Las Vegas desert. But remember that had he not been lost in that last round, McGuigan, and he not really faded, it would have been one of the great wins of all time. And there he is up at his new weight then, super featherweight, that's 9'4", and he came in right on the button, despite the, what I thought was a silly protest, really, from Thomas de Cruz's people, Carlos Peters, his name is. He was jumping up and down because he hadn't quite seen the scales balance, but in fact I was there also, and McGuigan came back and jumped on them again, and he was very relaxed, extremely relaxed. So remember now, it's a cool evening here at Luton, and he's got to keep working and working up a bit of a sweat there, McGuigan. The old Cockney firm there, the think tanks in his corner almost, Ernie Fossey and Jimmy Tibbs now. He's taken over from his former Irish trainers and thing now that he's changed camps and he's working under the Frank Warren banner. He's gone up to WBC number 6 on the strength of one win, only one fight in 22 months, McGuigan. So that's what the ratings committee think of him. He's always been quality, right back from his amateur days. Gold medalist at the Commonwealth Games, fought for Ireland in the Moscow Olympics. And we're going over to the announcer then, Peter Dennis, to introduce them.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event in this Frank Warren promotion from Luton Football Club, sponsored by Ryanair in association with the Luton International Airport. A super featherweight contest of 10 rounds, 3 minutes each round. The contest made at 9'5", 131 pounds. This is an elimination contest for the world title. Fighting out of the red corner, ranked number 4 in the world by the World Boxing Council with 30 wins, 17 of them by knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Francisco Tomás da Cruz. And fighting out of the blue corner in blue shorts with 32 contests, 30 wins. 22 by knockout from Ireland, the Clone Cyclone, the former featherweight champion of the world, the one and only Barry McGuigan. Gentlemen, please sit down in your seats. Would you please take your seats immediately? Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. At the weigh-in at 12 o'clock today, da Cruz scaled 9'3¾", 129¾ pounds. McGuigan scaled 9'4", 130 pounds. Your timekeeper, Mr. Teddy Turner. Your referee, Mr. Larry O'Connell.
So there it is now. Larry O'Connell's already obviously been into the dressing room with an interpreter, presumably, to talk to da Cruz. But da Cruz has fought in Europe before, not successfully with Chavez, who's now the present lightweight champion of the world. So He's really steamed up now, Barry McGuigan, but this fellow, good boxer, and his management say in boxing terms he's got a strong chin. Well, we'll find out. Scheduled for 10 rounds, and as you can see, he's got good advantage in height here, the Cruz. But the training drills of McGuigan again have been very impressive. He really is so much stronger, just 4 pounds heavier than as when he was world featherweight champion. And the last time he was in the open air on the football ground, of course, Queen's Park Rangers, who won the world championship against Pedrosa. Advanced chance of here we go for McGuigan, but I'm sure he's got a deaf ear to that. He's got too much on his mind at the moment. Well, I could see of the Cruz doing just a brief workout while he was in London. Got a pretty sharp right hand punch. He flicks with the left hand and then crosses with the right hand punch. Get his timing right now, McGuigan. It's never easy. Only one fight in 22 months. And that little split second between the impulse and action, that's when you've been out the ring for a while, that often happens in shows. Fancies himself as a bit of a moving Pele, Jim, this fellow. He comes from the same town. At least he lives in St. Paul, though. He comes from Recife.
Well, he is a slick boxer, but that was a good right hand from McGuigan there. Caught the Cruz a little bit high. Seemed to shake him slightly. I don't know if it's troubled him seriously, but it caught him just above the eyebrow and looked to shake him slightly. But McGuigan will obviously want a good start. He seemed a lot more keyed up in his comeback than he was in his first career. So we're looking for a good start to get right into this fight and get all his old confidence back. Another good right hand from McGuigan.
Just flicked past his chin there, Jim. Just a whisker. Surprising the length, actually, of McGuigan's arms, although the other fellow looks so much taller with a reach advantage. He has exceptional reach, McGuigan. It's deceptive. Well, a good searching round that, Jim, I thought, didn't you? Had a good look at each other, and he's not a bad boxer, this fella.
It was a good opening round. In the first minute and a half of the round, McGuigan was made to miss several times. And missed quite badly, but as the round progressed and towards the last minute of the round, he started to get through with his punches, get through with a couple of very good right hands, one which seemed to slightly shake the Cruz a little bit, but an excellent first round.
Meanwhile, he's getting the wash and brush up treatment there from Jimmy Tibbs, and in replay now, you see, what's this left hand, it goes through there, and then McGuigan starts to look to throw the right hand punch, so it doesn't quite unleash it at that point.
Ten seconds.
Coming out for the second round then. Very much a world championship eliminator this. They both come inside the super featherweight limit of 130 pounds, 9-4. McGuigan looks just a quarter of a pound heavier, doesn't mean anything. Sets his standards very high, McGuigan. He said, I don't want to talk negative about, but I'm not satisfied with my performance of not going on. I just want to get this one over and box well and satisfy myself. He worked so hard at the game. And as far as money's concerned, one would expect that he'd be safe for life anyway. He's now a company director. A little bit of a chess match they're playing here, Jim, aren't they? Trying to kid to each other a little bit to lead and counter.
Yeah, I've always felt that McGuigan is one of the best. You see, McGuigan's complaining about Cruz's head there. But I've always felt that McGuigan is one of the best pressure fighters Britain's ever produced. And he's now beginning to exert some of that pressure, pushing the Cruz back. This is what Barry does best, and this is what he must do.
Surprised at him complaining there. That's not normally Barry's game. He's been accurate with the body shots too, McGuigan. Sometimes he's been known to drop them low, but he's been very accurate so far with the left hook. That's the punch. The right hand over the top of the Cruz's left lead can do the damage there. There it is again, clipped right around the ear. And now he knows he can get through with it, McGuigan. He's going to let that punch go a lot. Watch for that. Oh, he's really got him on the hook here. This will be a really good performance, and he can do him in the second, and it looks like he's going to, because he's trying to cover up the Cruz, and he won't go down. He did this with Chavez. But now will Larry O'Connell give him every chance to come back? Yes, it looks as though he will. And he's fighting his way back. He's a gutsy guy. Because that really was a good salvo of shots there coming in from McGuigan.
He also came back with a good punch of his own. That was a solid hook that landed high in McGuigan's head. Certainly plenty of courage and a good chin, as his manager said before the fight.
Now we're coming up to the end of the second. Jim, have a look at this in replay then.
Well, we'll get McGuigan really took over there. Some tremendous punches. It looked as though the Cruz was going over, and just as it seemed it was all over, he came back with a cracking punch of his own. But at last, McGuigan has shown the power to trouble the Cruz, and that must have lifted his confidence tremendously. Look at the punches going through here. Very accurate, very solid all the way through. Doesn't leave the Cruz alone. Little bit of success, and Barry really opens up. But the Cruz come back with a good punch of his own just in the middle of this burst. Maybe we'll see that now. There it is. That's the punch he come back with. A good left hook of his own, but all Barry in that burst.
Round three. Well, he's really got the excitement back into the crowd now, but I tell you, the referee did well there, I thought, Leo O'Connor, to give the Cruz every chance, and I've seen Condé stop at that point many a time, but he quite rightly let him get on, because he really started to come back, as Jim Watt pointed out there.
Well, the Cruz is a world title contender. He's a world-class fighter, so the referee O'Connor gave him a chance to come back, and he did come back.
Got to really stand on his toes, as they say. McGuigan's got to always get in punching range, pushing the man back. Oh, doubled that up. Body switched it to the head. Brilliant right hand shot, those. Well, there's no ring rust there, Jim, is there? It really is good stuff.
Now, this is excellent stuff from McGuigan, even going back now and counter punching, showing us a little bit of everything, and you can see the extra power he has at the super featherweight. Far more comfortable at that poundage.
Oh, he's doing a job again here on the Cruz. The Cruz's gum shield comes flying out there. The referee's kicked it back to the corner there. The old promoter from Brazil, Abe Katznelson, working in the corner. The promoter trying to have another Irishman, John Corbell's fight with Ada Joffrey. That's the way to duck inside punches. They're wild shots, and McGuigan could see them coming, but still stood his ground, just moved his head enough. Minute to go in round three. Doubling up the punches again. He's looking to the corner, De Cruz, and that's a bad sign. He's looking for a way out here. Shall I go? He's holding on. He's brave enough there, and it looks as though he's dying for the referee to come in, because at this point he is not throwing punches back, or is he going to do as he did in the previous round? Soak it up and then try and come back.
If he doesn't throw something back, referee O'Connell's going to have to move in. He's doing nothing.
He's so wild too, Cruz, when he comes back. It's all desperation stuff right above us now, and it's a question surely how long Larry O'Connell's prepared to let this fellow take. He's not taking them all on the chin, and saved by the bell again, and falls into O'Connell's arms. But it's a long haul back for this fellow. And there's the elderly Abe Katznelson, who can hardly get in the ring. He must be top in 80 now, I would have thought. Nearly, anyway. And this fellow, he kind of ran out of ambition in the middle of it, Jim. Once they start looking to the corner, we may be able to see that in replay. No, it's got past that point.
I think McGuigan punched all the fight out of Cruz in that round. Cruz was looking over at his own corner, looking for some help, looking for some advice, and none was forthcoming. But McGuigan just kept the pressure all the way through. He didn't sag or lag, he didn't drop the pace. So obviously McGuigan is in excellent condition, far more power than Cruz has, and he's got control of this fight far sooner than anyone expected him.
10 seconds.
Get off.
So Larry O'Connell's been staring all through that round at Thomas De Cruz. He went to walk towards the corner. He didn't interfere. He let the seconds get on with it. Into round four. And it really is a world-class performance now by Barry McGuigan. This man's rated WBC number four, IBF number five. Have identical records. They're both 27 years old. It looks so much of an even match on paper, but there you go. Home ground advantage now for McGuigan. He only lives a left hook away from the Luton ground. Love the way he stands right in front of the cruiser. He's not scared to get inside punches, Jim. That takes a bit of doing.
No, well, this is the old McGuigan. We wondered if we would get him back again, but we do have him back again, because everything is as it was before. Good attack, good punches, good power, and good defence. It's really an excellent performance so far from McGuigan.
McGuigan really looking for that big finisher. He'd like this one to have the sort of finality of a gunfight, wouldn't he? That's the way back to show the Americans that I'm ready. And they're going right above us, and he really is showing the distress signals now in the fourth round. And yes, it's all over. There was inevitable finish, because even in his own corner there, De Cruz and the referee being compassionate with him as McGuigan jumps into the arms of his brother, who's always first in the ring, the ejector seat brother, I call him, with trainer Jimmy Tibbs, who said he's never trained such a more competent fighter in his life as this fellow. And Barry's back definitely in world class after that. We were a bit non-committal when he fought Nicky Perez at Alexander Palace. Has so much pride, Jim. He really is the true pro, isn't he?
That was a tremendous performance. He didn't just defeat De Cruz, he completely and totally dominated him. Cruz looked apart in the first round, but as soon as McGuigan raised the pace and really went to work, he got control of the fight and he kept control of the fight. He could have stopped Cruz in the earlier round, but he made no mistake there. Referee had no choice but to stop the fight.
There's his kick kid brother in there again with Barry. He was ducked through the security guard there as the official pictures are being taken. And, he's doing it well there, O'Connell. He's turning him round for the press, Fleet Street Brigade there. And a good moment there for Barry, isn't it? Being able to carry his youngster around there. And all this trimmings makes such good pictures for the newspaper, doesn't it? They love this man. He's just a natural, and all they say about him is true. He's a nice guy. And he'll thank everybody in sight directly afterwards. There was a certain, well, oozing confidence about him, wasn't there, Jim?
That was a tremendous performance all the
ladies
way through, and no one can say
Chavez's
performance against the Cruz was any better than that.
Of the fourth round, your referee Larry O'Connell stopped the fight to avoid further punishment to a very fine loser, ladies and gentlemen. But please let us welcome the future featherweight champion of the world, Barry McGuigan.
Well, he might have got the weight wrong there. It's due to featherweight champ of the world, he's saying. But there's still a way to go. It's bring on Rocky Lockridge, bring on Azuma Nelson, whoever wants it. This fella's back and he knows it. There's no question now that he will want to go on to challenge again for another championship.
For a very fine loser, ladies and gentlemen, Francisco Tomás da Cruz.
Barry, you said you wanted to find out a few things about yourself and about your future in this fight. What is the future for you?
I said I'm not going to put myself in the corner, Jim, and you're trying very difficultly to put me in the corner, but I'm not going to put myself at this stage. All I can say is I'm happy with that. He was very strong. I hit him with some good shots, and he would not go down. But he's a tough guy. Chavez only done him in 3 rounds, and he never put him down. And he gives Chavez a great fight. So I was very happy with it. I'm sharp, I'm quick, and I'm not missing the target too often. Right. I'm happy with that.
In your first fight, you were very self-critical. You said you were unhappy with your timing, but you got right into your work so quickly tonight. You must be delighted.
Yeah, well, I worked very hard for this one. All credit to Jimmy Tibbs. He put me into superb condition. I'm very, very happy with him. He's doing a marvellous job with me. And I think it showed tonight that I was on the ball, and I'm very, very pleased. I'm very thankful that Frank Martin has given me a chance to resume my career and become world champion again. I'm just very happy.
Millions of people watching here and watching in America. They're seeing the finish of the fight here, Barry. I'm sure you'll be delighted to see it once again.
Yeah, well, I see the left hook at the end there, but he was presenting very little target, and I was trying to hit him around the side, and a few times I was borderline, but I'm trying very hard to get that right. And I'm working very hard on it in the gym. I think I've got better combinations now. I'm throwing more punches, and Jimmy has done an amazing job with me as far as putting my combinations together. So, as you can see there, once I had him going, I never let him off the hook. He was a tough guy, but Jimmy just predicted it exactly right. He said, this guy's going to be a hard guy. Just like Frank, we both said it was going to be tough for a few rounds, but just keep on top of him. Keep picking away at him and he fought hard.
Next time in the ring, is it going to be for the world title?
That's a $60 million question.
That's why I asked it.
I know, I'm not going to answer it either. I'm going to go in for a day's have a rest, and I'm going to make my mind up.
A better Barry McGuigan second time round, you
I
feel?
I think so. A stronger Barry McGuigan anyway. And I think I proved that tonight. That's a fully fledged junior lightweight, a big man, and I've done the job.
And just a word about the support you've received here.
Marvellous, absolutely incredible. I'm very happy with it. They seem to have adapted me very well here at Luton. And who knows, Frank?
So what a stunning performance there by Barry McGuigan, literally. He did say to me yesterday at Henlow Grange that however pleased he was, he would assess the performances of Azuma Nelson, who of course won his fight this afternoon at Atlantic City with a 9th round stoppage, and Rocky Lockridge, the 2 world champions, and also reassess his own, and then he will take a decision on the next fight. Well, we'll take a short break, and when we return, it'll be that impressive, unbeaten welterweight.